According to a study Westinghouse did years and years ago, how much UVC energy does it take to kill a virus? And they found that it took 55 microwatts to kill bacteria and viruses. Our UVC bulbs are 190, so significantly stronger, higher kill rate, higher efficiency at killing.
Hi everybody, welcome back to the Air of Authority. Today we are talking about UV lights. Seems like a timely topic to cover at this point. We've actually been selling UV light and UV light systems for years, as long as I can remember. I have one myself. So today we're going to talk with Matt about how well they really work, if a UV light can kill a virus, and we're going to cover all of these frequently asked questions that we're getting a lot. Right. And please subscribe if you're a homeowner and you would like weekly tips on how to improve your heating and air conditioning system and save some money.
So what the main question is coming into us is, so we sell residential UV lights to install in your heating and air conditioning system. Mm-hmm. And what people want to know is, can UV lights like that kill viruses?
That's correct. No, UVC rays are used in a lot of different industries to kill and neutralize and sterilize. Sterilize is a more accurate word. Sterilize a virus. Industries across the board, it kind of got its start in meatpacking plants. They before they shrink wrap ground beef, and it's going down a conveyor belt, and it before it ends up shrink wrapped, it goes through a UV system, shining UVC light, germicidal light, onto that meat to sterilize and kill any bacteria that might be on it before it gets sent out. And now it's in water treatment. Hospitals are wheeling in, they refer to them as robots, but they're literally a tower that just shines light on the surface of the hospital room before they bring in a new patient. And now the new thing is, there's articles being written that they're creating a on wheels, a device that they roll in between the in the aisle of the airport and the airplane. And they're shining UVC light on the seats, lavatory, you know, the aisles. The bins.
What was the name of that again? It was something Falcon. Germ Falcon. Okay.
UVC rays are absolutely effective at sterilizing viruses.
So, but that's when on these product situation, the products are going right by a UV light. How effective? And we should also preface all of this by saying we are not medical people. We're heating and air conditioning people, and we sell a product that helps with these situations. So
yeah, and we've had homeowners that have had UV systems installed by us, and no exaggeration, 6 months later, have talked about how they used to have to take, you know, medication for a particular allergy or asthma flare-ups or whatever, and truly had homeowners that have said, I don't have to take it anymore.
Right.
And I'm not saying that's going to be the case with everybody, but UVC energy has been used for decades in hospitals and medical facilities to kill and sterilize germs, viruses, and bacteria. And right. Yeah, like you said, we're not medical professionals, but we are in an industry where we deal with airflow. And we also are residential service guys. So we're in people's homes, and the tighter we get our homes, the more we're breathing in the same air over and over and over again. And if one of your kids or a spouse comes home with a cold or the flu, you know, without anything aiding in sterilizing that virus in your home, your likelihood of getting it is pretty high.
What would you recommend if somebody was super intense on, like, I want the best that there is mm-hmm. available, at least for a residential home? What would you recommend?
We have a two bulb unit that our particular unit, one bulb is UVC rays, and that goes out there and neutralizes and sterilizes germs, bacteria, and viruses. So the CDC, Center of Disease Control, paints that into a danger level two. They call it danger level two, is they call it infectious agents. So that's germs, bacteria, viruses, things that make us sick, strep, the common cold, SARS, you know, the coronavirus fits into that. And that's what UVC helps with. The second bulb in our particular UV sterilization system that we have is, the second bulb is for neutralizing and cleansing the house of what's sometimes referred to as toxic compounds, sometimes referred to as VOCs, volatile organic compounds. That is the things like candles, aerosols, detergents, soaps, you know, those little Glade plug-ins that people love so much, Febreze, you know, these are all chemicals that we breathe. The paint on the walls, the carpet, you know, is full of chemicals. And we technically breathe that stuff all the time. And we really don't ventilate our homes very well anymore. So that little bulb is helping neutralize those chemicals. So yeah, UV energy in our particular unit, we're trying to take care of what the CDC says is danger level 2. So infectious agents, germs, bacteria, viruses, and danger level 3, which are those VOCs that I'm referring to. And those are the nasty ones. Those are the ones that everybody has. Everybody, if you have a carpet in your house or paint on your walls, there's VOCs present in the house.
If you want as close as you can get to hospital quality air, what kind of system would you recommend?
Well, I'd recommend something for particles for starters. You know, that's a some type of an air cleaner. Everything has a size to it. Even the coronavirus is, you know, got a size to it, 0.1, you know, microns. So it's very, very small. So that takes care of the particulates, the particles, smoke, dust mites, those kind of things.
Pollen. You're talking more filtration.
Filtration. Mm-hmm. And then danger level 2 is taken care of with UVC energy, which is what we've been referring to that everybody is doing right now. And from China to the United States, trying to kill germs, bacteria, and viruses. So that's the UV unit. And then in that same UV unit, we're able to help remove those VOCs out of the house. So we can kind of take care of all three of those danger levels by the CDC with those two products. It's something that the general public just needs to be more and more aware of when it comes to just the cleanliness of the air we breathe in our homes, that if you want cleaner, fresher, healthier air in your house, there's options out there, and UVC energy is really a great way to get it.
All right. Thanks, Matt.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Have a good day.